Hi, I'm Madison, Enablement Manager at Builder. In today's Builder 101 course, we're looking at the built-in components that Builder's SDK provides out of the box. There are plenty of basic elements to kickstart your visual content creation. We'll go through each block in detail, what they are, how they work, and some ideas on how you can use them together. We'll finish with how to style these blocks, then give a teaser into what more you can do when you start to add your own custom components. For this demo, I've created a simple Next.js website with a page template set up to insert builder content between an example header and footer. Let's get started. Basic elements. The first six blocks, text, image, button, columns, boxes, and sections, are our basic elements. They'll make up the majority of the types of elements you'll use to build almost any page. Let's start with the simplest item, the box block. If you're familiar with HTML, you can think of this like a div element. It's a simple container that can be styled with width, height, margins and padding, backgrounds and borders, etc., and most importantly, can have items placed inside it. Let's give it a border so we can see it more easily. The next most used block is text, because what point is a website without copy to read? Drag it onto the preview area to add a rich text editor input onto the page, and I can choose to put it inside, above, or below the box we just added. With the text block selected, you can start writing in the text box here in the options menu, but you can also double-click in the preview area to edit directly on the page. You can format the text using most standard keyboard shortcuts, like Control or Command B for bold, or by selecting the text and using the editor's buttons. Text can be styled in two ways: directly in the rich text editor field, which is great if you need to style parts of your text separately, or on the Styles tab in the editor, which will apply those styles to the whole block. A neat feature: when using the inline editor, you can type a forward slash to open an insert menu, letting you quickly add headers, images, lists, buttons, and more. Try this out the next time you're working on a new content entry. And speaking of buttons, the button block lets you create and style a button that you can use to link to another page. It's easy to modify the style to your liking. Hover state designs can be managed in the Animate tab by setting the trigger to hover, clicking the Edit button by Hover State, and choosing the desired button style when hovered. The Image block offers a quick and easy way to insert images onto your page. This block provides plenty of options to control how your image is displayed, from fit and position to aspect ratio and more. If the image has an alt text specified in the asset library, then it will automatically be copied here when selected. Or you can manually enter an alt text description for accessibility and SEO. They can be sized and styled on the Styles tab like any other block, but can also be used as a container. Simply drag another block into it and it will constrain to the child height, using the image like a background. Advanced features include an option to set priority for the image, preventing lazy loading, to fit the image to the child content, ignoring the aspect ratio, and an option to lock the aspect ratio, regardless of the image asset you select. Builder's image block optimizes images uploaded into our asset manager using web standards, best practices, and formats. This optimization only takes place with the image block, not on background images. So we recommend that you use the image block for optimal performance with Builder-hosted assets. Check out our docs for more details on working with images in Builder at the link below. The columns block offers a quick way to create evenly spaced content areas that collapse into a single column on mobile. You can choose from a few column presets or easily add new columns from the Options menu. You can click and drag to modify the column sizing and column gap spacing directly in the editor, or here in the Options menu if you want to manually enter in the values instead. Need to reorder the columns? Easy. Use the drag handles here. For making readable websites that scale well from mobile to large desktop screens, the section block is great for both setting max width content areas and making full bleed hero banners. This behavior could be recreated using just a box element, but we simplified the common use cases with this component and include additional features as well, like the option to lazy load the nested content. Quick tip. You can turn any block into a clickable navigation element by simply adding a relative or full URL path into the link URL field in the Options menu for that block. Putting it all together. Talking about each element helps explain how they work individually. Let's use all of these together to make a hero banner to better understand how builders' blocks might work together. We'll start with a section block to keep the content centered on the page and with a standard max width. We can use the Style tab to give this a gentle colored background. Then we'll add the Columns component to create a 50-50 split banner, and add an image to the left side. On the right, we'll add in a box, then a text element and a call to action button. Let's set the positioning here to center vertically and add some horizontal padding by shift-dragging the padding handle in the visual editor. And there you go. We quickly made a hero banner using just the basic building blocks. Sometimes you need a little more than just columns, text, and images to achieve your content goals. Let's look at a few more of the out-of-the-box blocks that Builder provides. Video and embed. Under the Media section, Builder provides two ways to add video into your content: a video component, which is similar to the image block, and the embed block. When uploading videos into Builder, the video block is Builder's best tool to add your videos to the content you're creating. This block includes a wide variety of features to render videos on your page, such as a static pre-video container image, whether it auto-plays or should show playback controls, if the video should automatically loop, etc. Especially if your video is below the fold, we suggest you keep the lazy load feature enabled in the advanced settings options. If your videos are already hosted on another platform, like YouTube or Vimeo, then you may want to use the embed block instead. All you need to do is paste in the URL of your externally hosted video, and you're done. Comparing these options, uploading a video directly to Builder offers better performance, full customization, and tighter integration, but does impact your bandwidth usage and can hinder discoverability of your video content. Embedding, on the other hand, provides free access to platform-specific features and can increase video discoverability through likes and subscribers, though with less customization. For shorter videos or animated backgrounds, we recommend uploading into Builder, while longer videos may be more suitable for embedding. To learn more about working with video in Builder's platform, check out our docs at the link below. But sometimes you need even more control over how your content is embedded. So that's why we have custom code. If you have an existing piece of HTML or need to integrate with a certain library you're already using on your site, the custom code block allows you to easily paste in whole sections of HTML and JavaScript. For example, I can paste in the embed code for this YouTube video, giving me much more control over the YouTube embed APIs. Symbol. The symbol component lets you insert another visual content entry within this page and isn't limited to only symbols. you can choose any visual content model to pull from. This could be a direct reference to a specific entry, or you can choose to make the reference dynamic, passing the same targeting values that the current content entry is targeting, and allowing for scheduled and/or A/B tested content entries to be referenced as well. An example would be inserting a hero banner section model that has several scheduled updates. When your page content is fetched, your users will get the appropriate version of that hero banner. Slot. The slot component is for making symbols with children. Reusable visual content components within Builder that can accept children block inputs. This is a somewhat advanced feature, so keep an eye out for the Symbols deep dive video for a longer explanation and examples on how to use it. If you need more interactive components, like accordions or carousels, we usually recommend custom components, built to your specific needs. However, Builder provides an optional widgets package that includes additional components. We'll cover those in our widgets explainer video. And there you have it, a comprehensive overview of Builder's built-in components. These powerful yet easy-to-use blocks are the foundation of Builder's visual development platform, designed to streamline your workflow and boost efficiency from idea to production. By mastering these built-in components, you're taking the first step towards unprecedented efficiency in creating web and mobile experiences. Whether you're a developer, marketer, or designer, Builder's visual CMS empowers you to build, iterate, and optimize independently, breaking down traditional bottlenecks in your content development process. Remember, Builder is all about integrating seamlessly with your existing design system and code. While these basic components offer incredible flexibility, they're just the starting point. In future videos, we'll explore how you can incorporate your own custom components, ensuring that everything you create in Builder aligns perfectly with your brand and development standards. Stay tuned for more Builder 101 courses, where we'll continue to explore the bold innovations that set Builder apart in solving the hard problems of digital experience creation. Thank you for watching, and we can't wait to see what you build next.